knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
We just learned about the history of the study of fingerprints. In this tutorial, we will discuss the physiology of the formation of fingerprint patterns on human skin and what makes them unique to each individual. Take a minute to examine the palm of your hand and your fingers. You will observe curious patterns of tiny circular or wavy lines forming hills and valleys all over your palm. Do you ever wonder what these raised lines are and what their purpose is? These lines serve the same purpose as the tread on a tire. The tread is the part of the tire that actually does come in contact with the road. A good tread pattern will enhance the grip of the tire with the road and also lead to effective braking. If the tread wears out, your vehicle will tend to skid. The lines on your palm serve the same purpose. They help humans in gripping an object. In the same way, the lines on the soles of your feet assist in walking. Due to their main function, which is to produce a force of friction between the hands or feet and a surface, these lines are called friction ridges. Also, you might observe a few larger lines like the ones dividing your fingers into three sections. Similar lines appear to divide your palm as well. These lines are known as creases, and their function is to facilitate the mobility of your hands and feet. Just notice how the palmar skin bends along these creases. Together, ridges and creases form friction ridge impressions. The skin enclosing both palms of the hand and soles of the feet is known as friction ridge skin. The spaces between these lines are known as valleys, or furrows, or grooves, similar to the grooves present between the tread of a tire. As a result, the friction ridges, together with the valleys, form a pattern. Every human being is born with friction ridge skin patterns, and they remain the same even after death. But what leads to the formation of this part of the skin? What causes the friction ridges to align in the particular pattern you're observing right now? Is there any genetic process linked to it? Indeed, it has been said that the genetic makeup of an individual may influence the formation of friction ridge skin impressions. However, genetics affects only the size and overall shape of the patterns. It does not play any role in determining the individual characteristics of each fingerprint at all. The proof of this lies in the fact that two identical twins share the same genetic makeup, yet possess a completely different set of fingerprints. In order to understand the formation of friction ridge patterns in detail, we'll have to discuss some embryological concepts. The average length of pregnancy, or gestation, is 40 weeks, so an unborn baby spends about 40 weeks in the mother's womb. The hands and feet of the fetus become recognizable by 6 to 13 weeks. Before this period, they just look like flat puddles. Eventually, somewhere around 8 to 12 weeks, some temporary bumps form on the fingers, palms, and feet of the fetus. These bumps are known as volar pads. You can observe them on your hand, the bumps on the tips of the fingers, below the fingers, and the bumps surrounding the palm. In the gestational period, they look like localized swellings and act as a canvas for the formation of ridge patterns. There are some growth and shape stresses in the womb acting on these volar pads. The direction of these stresses influences the direction in which the ridges will flow. Generally, the ridges on the hands and feet flow in a lateral direction. But when the ridge flow encounters the volar pads, which technically are just bumps on the skin, the ridge flow is redirected in a different direction. This is similar to the flow of water, which redirects itself upon encountering any obstacle or a bump. Now observe your palm and fingers again. Notice how the ridges on the fingers and the palm go in a general side-to-side direction. Next, pay attention to the bumps on the tips of the fingers and below the fingers, which were the volar pads. You will be able to observe that the general side-to-side ridge flow pattern is suddenly diverted upon encountering these bumps. The ridge flow now redirects itself from these bumps, giving rise to different intense patterns that look like a spiral or a loop. Different sizes and symmetries of volar pads give rise to different patterns. Look at the patterns here and compare them with your fingers. The three main fingerprint patterns shown are whorls, loops, and arches. You can see that they look exactly how their names suggest. We will discuss their characteristics in detail, but first, let us understand how they are shaped. Whorls are formed when the volar pads are high, symmetrical, and rounded. Loops are formed when the volar pads are asymmetrical, or when the bumps lean to one side more than the other. We can visualize this condition by looking at the loop pattern in the figure. In this loop pattern, it appears as if the ridges are flowing from a higher point to a lower point. This is because of the asymmetrical volar pad. The next pattern is the arch-shaped pattern. They are formed on a lower but symmetrical volar pad. As we mentioned earlier, it can be said that the genetic makeup of an individual does play a role in the overall shape and size of these patterns. This is because our hands and feet, enclosed by friction-ridged skin, are developed by a set of genetic expressions. The shape, form, and functions of our hands and feet are consistent throughout the total human population. Therefore, there are only limited ways in which the volar pads can develop, thus giving rise to a limited number of patterns. Nonetheless, the unique characteristics of these patterns are not hardwired into any genetic code. The individuality of the ridges and creases is attributed to random or chance events, often called developmental noise, or noise in gene expression. The hands and feet continue to grow even after the ridges are formed. Here, let's imagine a scenario. Draw a few parallel lines on a glove and wear it. The distance between the lines increases as the glove expands when worn. You would be able to draw another set of lines in the newly formed spaces between the parallel lines. Similarly, the friction-ridged skin will stretch when the hands and feet keep on growing in a fetus. Because of this, the existing ridges will start growing apart. Once the ridges reach a critical distance away from each other, new ridges are formed between them to ensure all of the skin is sufficiently ridged. This is why the ridge patterns are unique, as they are influenced by the unique force acting on a particular region of the hands and feet. Along with the growth rate of the fetus and the size of the volar pads, the mobility of the fetus inside the womb also influences these unique ridge characteristics. It is only after 18 weeks of gestation that new ridges stop forming and the ridge configuration gets locked for a lifetime, giving a human their own set of unique fingerprints and footprints. It's true that human limbs keep on growing even after birth, but the ridges remain the same, as their proportional relationship remains constant until death. With that, we have covered how two of the most important considerations for using fingerprints in forensic science come into being: their uniqueness and permanence. Let's move forward and discuss the different fingerprint patterns in detail.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.